Hello everyone, welcome to Learning Literature with Porba. In today's video, we are going to discuss the postmodern age. At first, we will look at the historical background of the age, then the literary features of the age, and finally we will look at the major writers of the age. So if you haven't yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, then do subscribe to it and hit the bell icon so that you never miss an update. So the postmodern age began after the Second World War in 1945. So from 1945 to 2000, this period can be called the postmodern age, the mid 20th and the late 20th century. Now we will take a look at the historical background of the postmodern age. After the Second World War, Britain lost its economic power that it had enjoyed for so many centuries, and the United States of America became the new superpower. Number 2, Cold War between countries. In the postmodern age, we could see cold wars between countries. Nuclear destruction, global conflict, and genocide became very common. And USA also did the Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombings on Japan in August 1945. So instead of any more world wars, we could see cold wars between countries. Technological advancement and space exploration. So that resulted in a lot of science fiction. Number 4. People accepted the fragmented and disoriented world. So in the modern age, people, especially writers, viewed the fragmented and materialistic world as tragedy. We can see that in T.S. Eliot's The Wasteland. But in the postmodern age, the people started accepting it as part and parcel of life. They understood that the materialistic life is beyond any redemption. Number 5. Multiple meanings. The postmodernists believed that there cannot be a single meaning or interpretation of a literary work. They believed that there can be endless meanings of a poem or a novel. So it is very similar to what post-structuralists said. Lastly, we have post-colonialism. In the postmodern age, we have post-colonialism, which is the cultural legacy of colonialism. It focuses on the consequences of control and exploitation of the colonized lands and people. So these are the things that happened in the postmodern age. Now we are going to look at the literary features of the postmodern age. The Theatre Act of 1968 was passed, which abolished censorship of theatre. As a result, theatre started blooming in Britain again, and we have great playwrights such as Samuel Beckett, Harold Pinter, John Osborne in the postmodern age. Number 2. The Theatre of Absurd. This is a literary movement in Britain that was pioneered by playwrights such as Samuel Beckett and Harold Pinter. So these playwrights were influenced by Albert Camus' essay, The Myth of Sisyphus. So The Myth of Sisyphus tells that there was this person called Sisyphus who was punished to roll a rock up on the hill. And again the hill used to roll down, and again he used to do the same thing and roll it upwards. So the common man's struggle in life is compared to that of Sisyphus's struggle. So that is what the Theatre of Absurd is based on. So the plays in the Theatre of Absurd, they do not have clear endings. Then the time and place are not clear. Then the actions of the characters are not logical, and there are symbolic representations and often long pauses amid dialogues. Number 3. The Angry Young Men Theatre. This was a literary movement that emerged in Britain after the Second World War. It was a revolt against the social inequality. It showed the frustration of lower class people. John Osborne, who wrote Look Back in Anger, belonged to this movement. Number 4. Confessional Poetry. This literary movement started in America during 1950 to 1960. So the poets wrote confessions in their poems. And the themes were divorce, depression, sexual abuse, death, mental illness, and many more. Some popular writers or poets who were in this movement of confessional poetry are Robert Lowell and Sylvia Plath. Number 5. Pastiche. So pastiche is the combination of various literary genres to create a unique narrative. So in the postmodern age, the writers took inspirations of previous literary genres to create a new unique style. So they used plenty of literary motifs and genres and pasted them together to create a new unique narrative. In novels, William S. Burroughs combined science fiction with detective fiction. So this is a classic example of pastiche. Number 6. Intertextuality. Intertextuality is the connection between related literary works. So the author acknowledges the previous literary work by means of quotes or allusions. A classic example is the novel White Sargasso Sea, written by Jean Rhys, which is actually a prequel of Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre. Now, Jane Eyre was written in the Victorian age. So this is a classic example of intertextuality. So there is the relation of Jane Eyre and White Sargasso Sea very closely. And the term intertextuality was first coined by Julia Kristeva. Number 7. Metafiction. It is the art of writing about writing. The author continually reminds the reader that they are reading a fictional work. Often, the reader is directly addressed by the author. Ted Hughes wrote a poem called The Thought Fox, which is about the process of writing poetry. So this is a classic example of metafiction. Number 8. Temporal Distortion. It is a narrative with a non-linear timeline. The story does not follow a chronological sequence. A classic example is Catch-22 by Joseph Heller. Number 9. Magic Realism. It is a literary genre in which the writer shows the real world while also adding magical elements into it. So it blurs the line between fantasy and reality. The events are realistic, but some magical elements are also added into it very skillfully. Some classic examples are Midnight's Children by Salman Rushdie. Number 10. Faction. Combination of fact and fiction. Faction is a type of historical novel where the writer depicts actual events that has occurred in history and also actual historical figures. But also he adds some fictional elements into it. So it is a combination of fact and fiction. Now let's take a look at the important writers of England who wrote during the postmodern age. Among novelists, we have J.R.R. Tolkien, Janet Winterson, Bram Stoker, Christopher Isherwood, Somerset Maugham, Muriel Spark, Angela Carter, J.K. Rowling, William Golding, Kingsley Amis, John Fowles, and many others. Among poets, we have Seamus Heaney, Ted Hughes, and Philip Larkin. Among playwrights, we have Samuel Beckett, Harold Pinter, Arnold Wesker, John Osborne, and Tom Stoppard. So that's it for today's video, where we discuss the postmodern age. If you found the video helpful, then do like it and share with your friends. And with that, we have completed our YouTube series, History of English Literature. Thank you so much, everyone, for giving so much of love and appreciation to this YouTube series. In our online academy, www.learningliteraturewithpoorba.com, we conduct the online course comprising live classes on History of English Literature with major writers. So we look at each age in depth and also study the major writers of each age. So batch 1 and 2 are currently going on and batch 3 will start on June. So if you need any help, then do visit our academy and register. I'll be back very soon with a new literary work. Thank you so much for watching and stay tuned to Learning Literature with Poorba.